How's it going, guys? It's Elf here, and today I'm bringing you a tutorial within Minecraft of how to build this simple starter house, would you call it? It looks like a starter house, so I'm just going to have a little fly around, show you what it looks like, and then I'll begin building it for you as well. So we've got the outside here, we've got some nice windows at the bottom, and then we've got some sort of like window basket type things at the top. So I wanted to make it a little different top and bottom. And the reason why there's no window at the bottom on this side and the other side is because that's where the stairs are. So it doesn't really look decent whilst there's a window with the stairs next to it. So I didn't bother including it. So that's the fly around from the outside. We've got a nice little path running along here as well. So let's jump in. Okay guys, let's get on with building this house. This is the shape that you are going to need. So as you can see, I've color coordinated it a little bit just so you can make it a little bit easier. But the whole little sections of this build are all 6x6. So keep that in mind whilst you are building this house. So let me get rid of all this wool and we'll begin. So on this first block here for the entrance, we need to replace these orange blocks with some oak wood. So we're going to go all the way around the build and place these on all the orange blocks. So we'll go like this, this one, and the front one's done. So after we've done that, we need to take our cobblestone out and just fill in between these areas at the bottom first. So we'll start down low and then we'll work our way up. Please, cow, don't get in the way, thank you. And we'll do two like that because we're going to have a double door here. So if you want to put your door in, we're just going to break the bottom blocks and just place the oak wood at the bottom so you know that is the entrance to the build. So after that, we're going to go up three more on this one. So we're going to go one, two, three. So it's a total of four. Cow, please move. So two, three, four, and keep going round. So there we go. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. And one more. There we go. So that's four up there. What we're going to do now is, guys, is fill the rest of this area in with some cobblestone without making any elfy mistakes. Let's go up. Let's keep going around. So we're going to fill the windows in a little bit later where we can see what the build starts to look like. So I'm going to fill all this house in with cobblestone and I'll be right back. So guys, as you can see, I filled the rest of the house in with cobblestone. Like I said, the windows will go there later on. But let's get this front part of the balcony on. As you can see on the house at the moment, this is what it looks like. So it's nice and easy to do. You should have all the oak wood from survival. And again, 6x6. So let's go across. Bring this one across here as well. We're going to leave a little gap in the middle. So this post can come down and go 2, 3, 4, and up we go. So that's the little bit where all the little plants are going to go underneath. So let's fill this little bit in so you know it's a balcony. So let's get our oak slabs and run these across here. And to top it off, we're going to put the fence across. If I am going too fast, just slow the video down, seeing as though YouTube's got that ability. And the reason why these have been left like this is because when you put the oak wood here, you put the oak wood there, it's going to cap it off so it will attach to the house itself. So they won't just, you know, dangle off the edge of the building like that and look a bit pointless. So they will, in fact, you know, attach just like this. So let's make this house one story taller and begin to put some windows in place. So guys, let's go one more taller, shall we? Let's go another four on top of this block. So it's one, two, three, four. And I'm going to do this all the way around the build. So let's do this one really quickly. So one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Once again on this side. And along the back, so one, two, three, four. One, two, three, and a four, and one more. You've guessed it, another four blocks. There's the fourth one. And again, guys, we're gonna do this whole section in cobblestone again, just so we know where the build, you know, literally looks like from the outside, so you can get a grasp of where the windows are going to go. Even on this side here, we're going to bring the cobblestone across, but on this side we're just going to go up and across and down on this side. We're going to leave this bit open for a doorway, and we will put some upside down stairs there as well a little bit later on, just to make it stand out a little bit more as a door would be there. So we're going to do this across here. I'm going to do the rest of this on video because it, you know, I didn't do the other one on video, so I'll do this one on. And we'll make this go across here and up. So this house really is easy to build. You know, simple, simple survival starter house. And, you know, there's nothing really to it. It's just wood, cobblestone, and some birch wood and glass. So guys, that's what it looks like on the outside with the cobblestone filled in. Now, I know you're probably thinking, wow, that's just a lot of cobblestone for a house, but it will look a lot like that. Don't worry, guys. So let's get the glass together and we'll start filling in the windows. Now it's time for the windows, guys. So we're going to come from the front of the build and we're going to fly across to the left hand side of your guys in survival. We'll be walking around. So we're going to miss this bottom block here and we're going to go up and break these four out and place the glass in between. So that's the left hand side. So we're going to skip this part because the staircase is there and on this side, I'm afraid. So we're going to come around to this block. We're going to break these four and, you guessed it, place some more panes in there. And on this side too, so you miss the bottom block and place them there. And then this side here is where the little garden is for the flowers. So we're going to miss that section out, but we are going to go up and do the second part. So we're going to fly up here, we're going to break these four and, whoops, elephant mistake, and put these under here. Now on this side, seeing as though the stairs are at the bottom, so we can't place the glass there, we can, however, place it at the top. So we're going to place the windows this side and on this side. So we'll place these here, fly up a little bit more so I can reach, and on this side too. And again, on the other side as well. So, you know, it's not really, you know, too hard to get glass panes, some nice little simple blocks, and you've got it. It's not that hard. And we're gonna do one on the front and finish that off there. So guys, I'm gonna get the materials out to do the roof, seeing as you can see where the windows are gonna go. All this detailing on the outside will come a little bit later on within the video, so don't panic, that will come. We're just gonna start on the roof. So this is what it looks like, and let's get the materials out to plonk that roof and stick it on this one. Here comes the tricky part, guys, the roof. So again, at the front of the building, we're going to come round to the left hand side like we did with the bottom window, and we're going to start with our oak wood stairs. So we're going to place one here just off of this block here, and then we're going to place a cobblestone right next to that one. So as you can see, that's what it looks like. We're going to build our way up, so that's two of them. We're going to also bring these upside down stairs underneath, so it's easier for us to place the roof line properly. So we're going to bring these across, so that's three of them. We're going to come round again, place another upside down one, place one on top of that one, so that will be four. And then we're going to come round to the other side. So once again, like on that side, we're going to place an oak stair on this one and a cobblestone on the outside. So we're going to do that there. We're going to place one upside down on this block, then we're going to build one on top. And again, the same again. So an upside down one, one on top, and the cobblestone next to it. And you guessed it, guys, you're gonna place one more upside down here, one on top, and the oak one, just like that. So that's what that part of the roof line looks like. So to make it that little bit easier, we're gonna do the same design here, just on this side right round here. So as you can see where this balcony is for the porch, we're just going to bring this one up here. So starting on this block, we've got our oak here, And we've got our cobblestone just on this one. So we're going to build this one up again. So that's two. We're going to build that across. And we're going to go upside down here as well. And upside down here, two. So we're going to bring this one across. So that's three of them. We're going to bring the cobblestone around one more. And go on top. And bring the oak on top as well. And then we're going to go around to this side. So we're at the back of the house now, guys. So we're going to bring this oak one, whoopsie, just across here. And the cobble on this side. Another one of the oak. And upside down for the cobble. And upside down once again. And place this one on top. Then we're going to do this. And then you've guessed it right, guys. Once more under here. And on top. So that's two of the overhangs done. So we've got this one and this one over here. So what we need to do now, guys, is grab your oak wood and just run them across on here and make sure they connect just like this. So let's keep going across and get this lining done. It's not too difficult. It might be a little harder in survival, so just build yourself up with some dirt and you shouldn't really have a problem. So let's continue running across here and connecting this side, making sure they all connect properly. And then we're going to scooch along to the other side. Bring this one across. In fact, no, we're going to bring this across in cobblestone. So, whoopsie. So you've got this line running around here and like that, and then you're going to bring the oak across. So where you put that cobble, you put the cobble here, you're going to have to get rid of the oak. So the oak one was there originally. Just to get the lining right, you're going to remove that and put the oak wood there. So you're going to bring this across, cap off the plank and bring this one across. So that's the only difference for the bottom. You just put in the cobblestone there. And then to finish the top of the roof off, just fill in the top section with the oak stairs. And voila, that is your roof done for the top. And in these gaps here, guys, just place your cobblestone just in between. So you just scooch along, reach in there, reach there, and fill that one in there, and on this side as well. Make sure when you are in survival you put some torches just inside there, just so nothing can spawn, just in case they decide to creep you out just a little bit with their groaning. So let's start with the windows on the outside. So give me 1 second whilst I get the materials. So guys, it's the windows to decorate just on the outside. So again, just the left hand side of the entrance, we're going to come around here and we're going to get our grass block and we're going to place them down just like this. Then you're going to get your trap door and place them across the front, and then you're just going to get yourself an oak wood stair and just place it upside down just here like this. And then you're going to place your flower of your choice just in the two grass block area. And then you're just going to get your oak wood slab and you're just going to come like this. So you're going to place one just in line with this window, place two across the top. Sheep, do you mind? Do you mind, my friend? Please scooch. Thank you. And place one on the bottom just like that. So we're going to do exactly the same on the bottom all the way around. So there's nothing here. So again, guys, two grass blocks, two trap doors, two oak wood stairs across the outside. Then you're going to place flowers of your choice and, you guessed it, the wooden little arch across the top of the window. So that's what that looks like. Then we're going to do it again on this side, just in case you didn't figure it out. So another two glass blocks and the upside down stairs and the trap doors. And then again, flowers of your choice. So we're going to go blue this time and red maybe. So that's the bottom one. We now need to work on the top design for the house. So it looks a lot similar, it really does. However, instead of making the stairs here, they turn into slabs and slabs across the top. So let me get the materials for that and let's begin the top part of the window design. So just got those materials for you guys. I do apologize, that was one of my mistakes on here. I did have these slabs here like this. I don't know why I did that when they were doing it in the beginning, but I have corrected it, so don't do that mistake like I did at the beginning. So let's come across to our build and come across to the left hand side once again, guys. So we're going to get our grass block again. We're going to place it here. Yes, it looks a little bit ugly, it looks disgusting, but we're then going to cap it off with the oak wooden trap doors. And then you're going to put your upside down stairs across here so you can't see the outside of the dirt. And then you're just going to get your oak fence and just attach it to the roof. Just like that. So it looks a little bit better, doesn't look too ugly. Then you're going to get some flowers of your choice on there. And we're going to do exactly the same around this side of the build. So just like this. So the trapdoors and the upside down stairs, flowers or ferns of your choice, and the oak fence just at the top. So we're going to do that all the way around again. So two grass blocks, two trapdoors, two upside down stairs, the oak wood fence attaching to the roof, and flowers of your choice. Again, grass blocks, trap doors, upside down oak wood stairs, and across here like this. So I'm going to do that for the rest of the house, guys, so give me 1 second. Right, guys, seeing as though I've done the rest of the build, let's see what this side looks like. So just to the right of the porch area, we've got this section here. Now what you need to do is you need to do exactly the same as what you did before. Just put your plants in there as well. There we go. And you're going to get your oak slabs. So you're going to run them across the top and just set them on top of the fence, just like that. So if you didn't grab that, we'll do it again on this side. So grass blocks at the bottom, trapdoors on this side with your, whoops, elfie mistake, with your oak upside down stairs and your fences coming at the top, and just across the top like this and down once again. Whoopsie, you need to put your plants in as well. My mistake, there we go. So that's what the windows look like, guys. So we've got one of that design there, we've got this design here, and the ones at the bottom just like that. And whoopsie, do you know what I've done, guys? I've missed this little section out. My mistake. So we need to put that one there as well. So if you did forget to put that in like I did, just put that in like that. So this is what the windows look like. I've done it there as well. I've done it there. My bad. Wow. I'm so bad. So this, guys, is the finished product for the outside. You just need to put your doorway in. So let me get rid of those plants, don't need that. So let's go down, find the door, oops, gone past it, put the doorway in on the inside, there we go. So you've got your door and your upside down stairs there. So let me clear my invent out, let's get the materials for the inside of the build. Okay guys, so you're on the inside part of your house, the exciting part, woo! So you need to break the layer of grass and you just need to replace it with some birch wood slabs or full blocks. So I'm going to do this for the whole entire house and I'll be right back. Now that you've put the birch wood flooring, guys, you need to work on this front part. So we're going to start with our brown carpet. We've got our nice little rug there, get rid of the dirty little soil from outside on the grass. So then you're going to get your upside down oak wood stair, Then you're going to place a pot on top and a flower of your choice. So let's grab a blue orchid like we did on the other build, and we'll get rid of the pot. I can't speak today, guys. And then you're going to grab your bookshelves and place two up here like so. And then you're going to get your chest and place a double one here and a double one just there as well. And we might add a painting in there just a little bit later on. But we're going to come round to the kitchen. Now, you're going to have to place two furnaces just like this. You've got a cauldron here, and you could place a full block or an upside down stair just there. Then you're going to place yourself a brewing stand just there. Then you're going to grab another set of double chests, and then you've got yourself a crafting table, and then you're going to grab yourself an anvil if you're that little bit better and more advanced and know how to build it, and just place it here on the end. So that is the kitchen, guys. That's what it looks like. Then you need to place the traditional white and black carpet. So we're gonna go white here and here, a black in between there, two blacks diagonal to this one, and the white in the middle, white on the edge, black in the middle, and then we're gonna go black here and white just like that. So that is the kitchen and the downstairs. Let me get the rest of the materials and start on the staircase and putting a roof on this floor. So I'll be right back. Okay guys, my mistake once again. It is my first time doing a tutorial like this, so there is going to be a couple of mistakes in between. You just want to place some windows just where the little rose garden's going to be. I do apologize for that, but let's get back on with the inside of the video. So guys, you're going to start with the staircase leading up. So you're going to want to skip this block here. So you're skipping this one and you're skipping this one. And on this block here, you're going to place the stairs just here. So we're going to go upside down on this one and start building up. So this is what it's going to look like. And we're going to scooch in this side just here and place the upside down one just there. Then you're going to come to this side here and you're going to start going up. And then we're going to place an upside down one there. Yep. And up here, just like that. And one upside down there. So then this is where the floor is going to start. So you want to fill all this section in. It may be difficult, but if you can do it from underneath, that's just fine. So you're going to bring this all the way across for the rest of the house. Whoopsie. And this is what it will start to look like. So I do apologize again, guys. Like I said, it's my first time doing a tutorial on Minecraft for a house. Everything else I've done has been in creative and whatnot from my previous builds, but this is what this is going to look like. You're going to come down here, make sure you don't bump your head on the way down, and that's the staircase in place. And once again, guys, you just want to place some torches on each of the beams just here like this, and one there and there, so the inside is lit up nicely. You can place birch up along this roof line if you want, so I'm just going to do this as well. On the other house it was the oak slabs, but keep in mind, let's just keep it all the same, shall we, with the birch running through. Like I said, just in case nothing can spawn on these, we're just going to place... No, we're not going to place some torches because I use four blocks on the other side. So nothing spawns on slabs, so we're all safe with that one. Another mistake on my part. So let's fill this one in just there like that. And voila, that is the upstairs where it looks like at the moment. So let me grab the bed and some more bookcases and whatnot, and I'll be right back. So guys, I've got the materials. Let's start off placing the beds in. So we've got a nice double bed just here. Then we're going to place another little plant pot down here and a red tulip. Red being my favourite colour, so we're going to keep a nice little red theme. Then you're going to get some single chests and just build them up here. We're not going to build it up there because, you know, it doesn't look that good, but you can if you want. But I'm just going to leave it down just like that so you can reach it a little bit easier. And then we're going to come round to this side here. You're going to place a bookshelf, which I haven't got out. So let's place a bookshelf down. So we're going to place two here. Can place three if you want. But for the simplicity, because it is a starter house, I'm going to place just the two. And then on this side here, just a nice painting, just like that. And then on the outside here, you're going to place some upside down cobblestone stairs. And that is the tutorial for this house. It's nice and simple. Maybe if you want, just add a couple of torches on the outside here, just so nothing spawns. And there you go. The house is complete. You've got the upstairs. It is nice and simple. Like I said, if you want, add another chest here. Add another bookcase just along here. And that is what it looks like. But like I said, I'm going to keep these down here just like this. We're going to cap this staircase off here as well. Let's move this across here. Don't need the torches. So you're going to move that across there. And then we're going to finish it off, guys, once more with a little painting just there. So let's do a little bit of decorating on the outside. Seeing as though the inside is done, we're just going to add the plants in this little bay here. And that should be it. So give me one moment, let me get my breath, and we'll be right back. Okay, guys, so we're on the outside now. So just underneath this little balcony section, we're just going to place some coarse dirt randomly. Just make it that little bit nicer. Place one there and maybe one there like that. Maybe one there. And then you're just going to randomly place some bushes down and it just make it that little bit fancy just to see what this area would look like if it was nice and flowery and stuff like that. So we're going to do this like that. Maybe add another one of those there. And that is the outside of the house as well. If you do want, you can add a fence in just like that. So all you need to do is go down, grab your oak wood fence and just randomly scatter it across here like that and whatnot. Make a nice little entrance and get rid of this one. Don't need that one. Just make it a little bit random and scattered. And that's what it would look like. So you can build it like that, then just break one in between and whatnot. And then you just add the gravel and whatnot underneath here. So that, basically guys, is what the house looks like. Again, you don't have to add that fencing if you don't want, but I haven't got enough room to finish it off because of the house. Like I said, this is what it looks like, a perfect example. So if you want to get maybe a screenshot of that, maybe just take some tips, just randomly then scatter some dirt and gravel in between. And that is basically the house done, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. This is the outside, once again, of your creation. You've got the nice roof coming across the top. You've got the hanging baskets for the windows and the ones on the bottom as well. You've got the ones on the back, like I said. You haven't got any at the back on the bottom because of the stairs. And then the outside on this one. Then if we scoot on, you've got the inside of the house. You need to close the door behind you. You've got a nice inside kitchen as well. Then you've got the upstairs here. So guys, I really hope you enjoyed this build. It took quite a while to think of it. So if you did enjoy it, please leave a rating, leave some comments. And I'll try and think of another design for a simple survival house very soon. I hope you enjoyed. Please take care and I'll see you in the next video. Bye guys.